Attraction.
Fantasmic, the ultimate Disney nighttime show. A full-blown spectacle of sight, sound, and synergy. But as I've mentioned before, I've only ever seen the East Coast version of Fantasmic. This show started with me comparing the East and the West Coast, so if only I had a line of dialogue that was an obvious setup for a special appearance by a Disneyland expert or two.
So you see, if Walt Disney hadn't died, they never could have used his still-beating heart to power the hitchhiking ghost animatronic. It's all explained in my manifesto. You!
Oh hey, some jerk with a camera, how's it going?
Don't oh hey, some jerk with a camera, how's it going? Me, Gansley!
That's not how my last name is pronounced.
I'll mispronounce your last name all I want. You stole my idea for a Disney Park review show.
Okay, in my defense, I started filming and editing my Disney Park review show long before yours premiered. I just didn't finish it until afterwards.
Aha! Then you admit that you also stole my idea of taking forever to finish an episode!
Hey, I would have procrastinated long ago, I just kept putting it off. Besides, our shows are totally different.
How? How are our shows different?
Well, for one thing, people actually watch your show.
They do?
You know, I made a Disneyland video before either of you two.
Spazzmaster, go find my keys.
No.
Well, since you're both here, you guys want to review Fantasmic with me?
Forget it! I refuse to be an accessory to the theft of my own format! Besides, I'll never forgive you for letting that jerk me beat me and is it still there? I still have the whip marks, let me show you.
Oh dear God in heaven, no.
Okay then! Spazzmaster, what about you?
Actually, I was gonna see World of Color tonight.
Come on, please? I'll think about maybe possibly considering to maybe submit something to the next Call It What You Like.
Alright, Fantasmic, let's do this!
Kiss ass! Now, where'd I put my keys?
Fantasmic was developed by Disneyland Entertainment in association with Walt Disney Imagineering and Walt Disney Feature Animation. That's right, it took three whole arms of a giant corporate behemoth to pull this show off. Of course, Disney has so many arms that three of them might not seem like that big a deal, but it's still quite a bit of collaboration for a single attraction that would only be experienced twice a day, and the fact that they put so much force behind it shows just how seriously they were taking this show, and just how seriously they continue to take it with an estimated budget of the $25,000 to $75,000 range per performance.
Of course, like any attraction, the idea didn't come fully formed. There were many attempts over the years to develop more Disneyland nighttime shows as a fun incentive for guests to actually stay long enough to buy dinner, Santa Ana Freeway be damned. Barnett Ricci, who would later direct Fantasmic, tried developing a similar special effects show for the castle around Disneyland's 35th anniversary. There was even an idea for another Rivers of America show focused around the Haunted Mansion, with the ghosts floating out of the mansion and towards the river, but they just didn't have the effects technology yet to do that idea justice. It wasn't until they discovered a French company's prototype for a water projection screen that the pieces fell into place. And now that the original Illuminations was already a hit at Epcot, it was officially time to move forward on a Disneyland waterfront nighttime spectacular.
While the bulk of the show was designed around resources already present at the location, such as the sailing ship Columbia and the Mark Twain riverboat, they still had to close off Tom Sawyer's Island and drain the river in order to build a new stage with trap doors, laser effects, and pyrotechnics, as well as fountains in the river to create those newfangled water screens. And then there was the content the screens would display. Keep in mind, this was before any schmuck with a half-decent laptop could manipulate footage in any way they wanted. And even though there's very little, if any, completely new animation for the show, the Disneyland team still had to work closely with the feature animation department and use all their resources to generate movie clips that would fit into the show perfectly. The show was supposed to premiere on April 29th, 1992, but then the LA riots happened. And the original tagline for Fantasmic was, "Be here when the night ignites." Awkward.
And here's what they did to the executive who came up with that slogan.
Wait, stop. You were gonna cut to footage of the Rodney King beatings, weren't you?
What? No, that would have been an extremely poor taste. I was gonna cut to footage of 9/11. Now who's stupid?
So the executive who came up with the slogan was a 100-story building.
Yep.
And as punishment, they crashed a plane into him.
You do not cross Disney.
As I was saying, the premiere was pushed back 2 weeks, and despite the awkward start, the show became such a massive hit that Disney decided the East Coast needed a version of the show as well. But unlike the West Coast version, this wouldn't be at the Rivers of America. No, Magic Kingdom has enough attendance already. But MGM Studios? They needed a bit of a boost. So they built the Hollywood Hills Amphitheater in a space that used to be a cast member parking lot. Because Michael Eisner won't rest until every parking lot in the world is destroyed.
So there was finally a reason to stay at MGM Studios all day. Of course, now you'd be at Hollywood Studios all day just waiting in line for Toy Story Mania. The new amphitheater allowed them to devote more space to the show, with a larger stage and its own specialized merchandise and dining experience. But this also meant that the East Coast show didn't have the pre-existing resources that the West Coast show had, and they had to rebuild everything from scratch. So some of the sets are noticeably cheaper than their West Coast counterparts, which is one of many issues a lot of theme park enthusiasts have with this version. But considering your average theme park guest apparently thinks Disney gift cards work at SeaWorld, a few differences between coasts won't stop the show from being extremely popular, and you might have to get here very early for a good seat.
Of course, they not only had to build a new stadium, they also had to prepare for the biggest difference between Florida and California. The likeliness of inclement weather. So when it's too rainy to safely perform the show, they perform an alternate, shorter show called A Taste of Fantasmic, which features the fountains, the fireworks, and a soundtrack that includes Bambi's Little April Showers. But none of the actors are movie clips. It's nice that they at least do something for the people who have been waiting all day to see the show, but it's a bit like gearing up for a midnight screening of Avengers 2, only to have it preempted by an episode of Hanna-Barbera's Fantastic Four cartoon.
And I don't want to see that.
Originally, the show was going to simply be called Imagination, but they couldn't trademark that name. And of course, the inability to trademark a word has led to some of the greatest marketing decisions in history, so they called it Fantasmic. Which raises an interesting question.
What does Fantasmic even mean?
Good question, pre-recorded footage of the time my best friend from high school visited me here. What does Fantasmic mean? Obviously it's a play on the word fantastic, but with an M. For magic, or Mickey, or money grubbing.
It's probably supposed to be a cross between fantastic and phantasm, or phantasmagoria, emphasizing the villain aspect or the ghostly lighting effects.
You foolish fool, it's clearly a cross between fantastic and orgasmic. The show is about Mickey's sex dream.
Wait, seriously?
Don't be blinded by your childlike view of Disney innocence, you naive clod.
Jerk, do you want to be in the review or not?
Only when I get to insult you. Or cut to 9/11 footage.
Come on, I already have a guy for both of those things.
So, you don't have any friends on your own coast, do you, Gansel? You're like the 9/11 of people. I brought a clip to demonstrate.
And moving on.
So while we wait for the show to begin, we might get a performance from a Dixieland jazz band. Or the Cadaver Dans if it's Halloween time.
Yeah, not in Florida. For a long time, we had no pre-show, just god-awful pop remixes of Disney songs, occasionally interrupted by various safety announcements.
And for the safety of our performers, the use of laser pointers during the performance is strictly prohibited.
Because seriously, it's not 1998 anymore.
Fantasmic will begin in just 15 minutes. During the performance, the lights in the theater will be dim. Please remain in your seats until the lighting level returns to normal. We would like to remind you that the lights in the theater will be dimmed during the performance.
Does the audience really need this much warning for a drop in lighting?
All right, Expedition Everest, this ride is awesome! And holy crap, what happened to the lights? Oh no, what do I know? No. Oh, cool, we're going backwards! This ride is so awesome! And holy crap, it's dark again! Oh no, I can't see any of my loved ones! I'm completely alone in the universe now!
No one likes the dark.
But then they finally added a pre-show with two young, hip, with-it co-hosts going around doing various audience participation things. Wait, audience participation? In Hollywood Studios? Unprecedented! This goes on for... a while. Until mercifully, we reach the final bit of pre-show, the introductory narration.
Nothing is more wonderful than the imagination. For in a moment, you can experience a beautiful fantasy or an exciting adventure.
In fact, why the hell did you spend so much money on park tickets? You could have just stayed home and imagined a wonderful vacation. We even have video games to help you. By the way, the lights in the arena will be dimmed.
But beware. Nothing is more powerful than the imagination.
I'm imagining myself a multimillionaire who's dating Alison Brie. Doesn't seem to be working.
Your imagination is impotent. Come, Alison, let us go through Rock's Hall.
All right, it's time for the show to be. Wait, what the hell is that?
Ah, you'll get used to it.
After every night I have the strangest dreams. Doctor, listen to me, tell me what this means. First I'm going shopping in my underwear. Then all of a sudden I'm floating in midair. My lips fall off and everybody starts to stare. Donuts and hot dogs are flying everywhere. Now, Doctor, wait a minute, you ain't heard nothing yet. Next comes the part that I...